daily vomit. Here's another one. Officers of the 76th Russian Shock Troops Division operating in Ukraine. That was Zero Hedge reporting it before Reuters. As usual, the alternative media is the real media, breaking everything. 9 times out of 10, the alternative media is accurate and the mainstream's not, I'm telling you. We are not the alternative. We are now the dominant media. We have bigger audiences, everything. And our budgets are getting as big as the establishment because the establishment bankers won't even put money behind MSNBC and CNN anymore because they don't even have the audiences of a local radio show. So they really are the mouse that couldn't roar. So that's just some of the news. Ukraine crisis. Moscow catches the world off guard. London Independent. It's run by a former Russian oligarch, I should just add for you. Rogers says Putin running circles around the U.S. Already basically got into that article. Ukraine, Putin's Crimea aim is to make the West look weak. The real purpose of Russian troops in Ukraine is to undermine the credibility of NATO. No, London Telegraph, that's anti-Russian historically. The NATO is running up against the Russian border, and the Russians actually look weak, so they basically just secured their military bases on their border that they already had in Ukraine. And I hope they're restrained, and this doesn't turn into nuclear war. To which the neocons respond, I'm a Russian sympathizer. I'm not a sympathizer with Assad over in Syria. I just don't want to fund al-Qaeda to go in there and blow the whole place up and blow up 200 churches plus, or whatever it was, it's 500 total, estimated, in Syria and murder everybody. I mean, I'm not for al-Qaeda. And I apologize that I'm not for al-Qaeda. I know that's not trendy. I know that's seen as extreme. But, you know, as Rand Paul, another extremist, said, you know, we shouldn't be providing, or Ted Cruz said the same thing, an Air Force for al-Qaeda. And that's, he also, Ted Cruz, said that Obamacare would double your premiums, and it did. But he's a bad guy for telling the truth. So I apologize for that as well. I apologize for telling you Obamacare was a giant screw job, even though it is. So there, I'm being trendy now. Ukraine crisis test Obama's foreign policy focus on diplomacy over military force. That's out of the Washington Post. Russia moves to deploy troops in Ukraine. That's the Wall Street Journal reporting days after it happened. We could just show local news reporting, and that's what we do. But see, media in the West will never show what foreign media shows because it's all about how they're in control. So they only tell you days after when they can put it out themselves. Now, we've talked a lot about this big story. There's a bunch of other ones. Let me mention these that are coming up in the next segment. Sub-zero temperature days reaching record levels in the Midwest, killing people, causing power outages, unprecedented cold, maybe the coldest winter in 100 years, top meteorologists and meteorologist historians are saying. Billings reaches previous February snow record, 14.4 inches. Great Lakes approaches 100% ice cover for the first time on record in 300 years of recorded known history of the Great Lakes. That's from NOAA. That's the federal government. This is global warming, ladies and gentlemen. We didn't pay the money to Al Gore, so he said we'd all have melted ice caps by 2013. Of course, they got bigger than ever. That's going on. Separatist blame for China knife attack. Kill 33. Well, it's the knives' fault. Ban knives. They came out and did it. Ban guns, too. Somalian leaders want female genitals cut. We're going to cover all this, but this is not the important news. I've got all the Hollywood news, all the Oscar news that really matters, and the football news coming up.
Obama, Obama.
Bang your head into Obama's loving arms.
You want to stop tyranny? Well, so does he. Live from the Infowars.com studios, it's Alex Jones.
Hey, folks, just buy into the fraud. Bang your head into the lies of the New World Order. Embrace the dead. Embrace the tyranny. I think this song actually says it all, ladies and gentlemen. I'm an axe grinder. Pile driver. Mama says that I never, never mind her. I'm insane.
The teacher says that I'm one big.
Oh, here's the key. Up against the wall of tyranny. Don't bang your head going along with the system. That is banging your head up against a brick wall. Bang your head up against the New World Order's head, and we're going to see who gives up first. And I'll assure you, our heads are bigger, stronger, our necks are bigger than these chicken neck control freaks that want to run society into the ground. Oh, best part. I really want to be overrated.
I'm a finder.
And I'm a keeper.
I'm a keeper. I'm not a loser.
And I ain't no weeper. Listen, folks, we have the people to defeat the New World Order. We have the morals on our side. And it's time that we speak out against the globalists. Look, in closing, I'll say this about the situation in the Crimea, there in Central Eastern Europe, what's happening with Russia, with NATO, with the EU. The EU is sucking every country dry. The bureaucrats are exempt from taxes. Look it up. They are robbing everything, attacking the family, bringing in Agenda 21 environmental tyranny, total NSA-style spying, tracker chips in all the cars. Europe is a nightmare situation. People are running from the EU trying to get out. Most of the nations never voted to join it, like the UK. I have members of the UK Parliament on. I have members of the EU Parliament all the time. It is a nightmare. Even the elected groups can't vote to get out of it. And you've got this low moral, high ground, criminal new Soviet trying to take Eastern Europe over to suck them dry. The banksters openly want to suck Ukraine dry. The breadbasket of not just Russia, but Europe to a great extent with wheat and other staple production crops. And you've got all this going on. And the last 5 years, there's been all these attempts to overthrow the Russian government by the West and George Soros. And they're picking a fight with the Russian bear, folks, that isn't perfect. But compared to George Soros, the Nazi collaborator, I mean, Putin was a Nazi collaborator when he was 15 years old and said he was proud of it, basically, like George Soros did on 60 Minutes, that he had no problem with what he did. So, you know, I just George Soros is trying to overthrow the Second Amendment and free speech here and trying to do it in Russia. And, I mean, I'm sick of him. I mean, haven't you had enough time on the planet? Haven't you done enough evil, Soros? I mean, is there no end to what you're up to? But I don't want to get off into some jag about George Soros. I just want to vomit. I want to vomit at his activities. I mean, he funds millions of dollars to groups like Media Matters run by the White House that openly call for free speech to be shut down and say my show is evil and I'm calling for violence and all these lies. They're connected into groups like Raw Story. Look at this headline. Tucker Carlson and Alex Jones, who was in the studio with us Friday for an hour, Democratic Party, now the KKK, but with minorities. Well, the KKK was race politics, and the Democrats ran the KKK till the 60s, and Eisenhower passed the Civil Rights Act, and the Republicans did it. They were the anti-slavery party, folks. And so the Democrats flipped into race politics with minorities. And what we said is, for anybody who's informed, is total truth. I'm not saying Republicans are perfect, and I said that. They edited it up. And the great part is the first line is, Fox News host Tucker Carlson appeared on right-wing conspiracy enthusiast Alex Jones' internet-only radio show on Friday. This Sunday show's on over 90 stations on record, some big, some small, all across the country, 590 a.m., formerly owned by President Lyndon Johnson, one of the top stations in the state. I'm broadcasting right here from my own studios in South Austin. We're on that station. We're on in Chicago. We're on into New York City. We're on into Los Angeles. I say into Los Angeles. We're on a station right outside L.A. We're on all over Oregon. We're on over 160 stations weekdays, 80, 90 stations. It varies on the Sunday show. We're on in Knoxville, Tennessee. We're on, I mean, it's on record. I mean, the 100,000-watt FM. And then another station, AM. In Knoxville, WBCR. I could just keep listing and neurotically. I know 10 stations in Oklahoma, 8 stations in Arkansas, Kansas. We're on Kansas City, St. Louis. AMF, but that's not even, I mean, that's a big part of our audience. I started out on 98.9 here in Austin. It's not talk anymore. It's music. Started out there. Station didn't have a lot of ratings. I had great ratings. That's where I got launched into syndication. I went on a station with didn't have any ratings. I had better ratings than Howard Stern did on the local station. And he had decent ratings for that station. The other station shows didn't have any ratings. It's Howard Stern and my show at night. I was on the weekend. 22 years old. Man, you got some ratings here. We're giving you a weeknight show. Well, you're doing good in the ratings there again, boy. I mean, I've been on AM and FM radio since 1996. I'm in the top 25 in Talkers Magazine of terrestrial radio. I have a million visitors to Infowars.com every day. 300,000 to PrisonPlanet.com. Millions to MySpace. Back when that was big, a day. Millions to our Facebooks today. Huge, everywhere. Just, I can't even aggregate my audience. It's so huge. But they want to control reality and say, it's basically like saying no one put gasoline in their cars today. Let me read this. Tucker Carlson and Alex Jones are absolutely exposing the fact that the Democratic Party was run and founded by the Ku Klux Klan, basically, in the modern age, and fought against the Republicans in Lincoln, and has been the party of slavery and division all along, and demographically couldn't win anymore. I mean, that should be the headline, but instead it's Tucker Carlson and Alex Jones, Democratic Party, now the KKK, but with minorities. Fox News host Tucker, why not say he's internet only? Internet only, Tucker Carlson. Internet only is the Daily Caller, like dominating, you know, as big as the New York Times online. Been around 4 years. I mean, how do you like that, morons? The Drudge Report on record, International Studies, the New York Times admits, has more traffic and sets news headlines better than Twitter, Facebook, the New York Times, and the Washington Post confirmed. Why not just say Drudge is internet only? Drudge, you're internet only. I mean, these are like 70-pound 8-year-olds. 9-year-olds outside of a heavyweight boxing match or a UFC championship in Las Vegas saying those guys are wimps in there, we could kick their butts. I mean, this is all these little, and the only reason I mention this because they're pathetic and small is to show how pathetic they are. Piers Morgan, 380,000 viewers. A local radio show has more than that sometimes, you know, on a big station, more. These people are literally living in their own minds. My show in every metric, exploding. Their websites, their news sites, imploding. Alternative media is the new dominant media. We're rising, they're imploding. And what is their sniveling, lying response as you listen to me on AM and FM stations from Needles, California to Knoxville, Tennessee? Stations in Buffalo and Rochester and towns outside Manhattan, going into Manhattan, and stations beaming into Los Angeles, and stations beaming all over Texas, and in West Texas, East Texas, South Texas, Central Texas, AM and FM affiliates, Tampa, Florida, just back on the air where we were number one for a while, and the stations changed hands, and back on in, well, where's Disney World I visited? The big Orlando, boom, 80 or whatever, the big talker. I'm just dominating. I am not on AM and FM. You heard them. The Democrats said it. I am not even, in fact, I don't even have any listeners, folks. In fact, I don't even exist. You understand that? Matt Drudge doesn't have 10, 15 million viewers a day, readers, and can set the news agenda 10 times bigger than the New York Times ever could. No, no, he has nobody. Infowars.com, nobody. And I'm on no AMMs, no FMs, nothing, nobody. I don't have films. I didn't produce the number one downloaded film in history with over 180 million downloads now and views, loose change. I didn't produce films seen 50 million times, 40 million times, 20 million times. I haven't sold millions of DVDs. I am nobody. I am nothing. Raw story. Nobody organization said so, and they control reality. Global warming's real and gonna kill you if you don't pay Al Gore. They're right. Carbon taxes are good. Ban all the guns, it makes us safe. You can keep your doctor, Obama tells the truth. There's no NSA spying. Nothing's a lie. Nothing's the fraud. Listen, the Democrats are not connected to the KKK. They're not race baiters. You're right. I have no audience. I'm on no stations. There's no second hour coming up. That's a lie, too, because I'm on no stations. It's all a lie. You're right. You're God.
From his Central Texas Command Center, deep behind enemy lines, the information war continues. It's Alex Jones and the GCN Radio Network.
Mainstream news is even reporting what we told you years ago. Massive drone operations are being launched all over the United States. Police departments are spying on everything you're doing without warrants beyond the NSA. We're going to get into that at LA Weekly. We've got just all sorts of insanely important news.